Kenneth, so when I wanted to ask you for advice, actually, for a medical student right now, because from knowing you personally, I know that you haven't just come up out of the blue now to be working for NIHR, to be having all these publications, to be living in America. You've been to the UK, like you didn't just come up suddenly like that. It came from a long time ago. So can you just tell us a little bit of your story and advice for people who are out there, especially younger people who might be in medical school, maybe even in S6 VAC?
So my love to, to study from UK really started from my S6 vacation. I really wanted to study from my UK because I got to work with, I think my S6 vacation job, I was working in a Forex bureau and my managers had studied in the UK. And I really loved how they were doing their things. They were different from the other, other people who had not gone to the UK, how they were doing their things. So I loved how they were doing their things. But even before that, I had a relative who wanted also to study from there after her bachelor's. So we were in that time of enlightenment that, so we did so much searches on UK universities. I applied for some. I got in, but had no funding, scholarships to go and study bachelor's degrees there. But so anyway, I stayed in Makerere University. But since I had gone through the applications of scholarships for my bachelor's, I knew the requirements, some of the requirements for some of those scholarships. So I knew I needed to have very good grades, be like in the top 5%. I knew I needed to have like mentors, like lecturers who know me. So I had to make sure that I get to know lecturers and they get to know me. I actually had a very I knew most lecturers, and whenever I would ask for a recommendation letter, I would get it, like easily, because I whenever they were teaching, I was active, attentive, and yeah, because I knew what I would
You
want
knew
from
what you
them.
wanted.
I knew what I would want from them in future. And yeah, and I got good grades.
Tell us your grades. Why are you not at the top of the class?
Just that class, the entire college.
The entire college. To God be the glory. So, Kenneth, you're top of
My cohort, I
the
think,
class.
has
You are top of
as
the
on top of that of my cohort.
your cohort.
And I think the entire College of Health Sciences.
And then you
But
went to
those
Yale.
don't count in medicine, but they count in your applications for further studies. So some people will be like, oh, but they don't count in medicine, they don't count degrees, points, and stuff. But when you're going to apply for studies elsewhere
Elsewhere.
outside Uganda, they'll look at your CGPA, especially if you're applying for top universities. I know there are people who have applied and gotten, studies with not as good grades, but those are not many. Sometimes the grades speak louder for you, and they will never tell you what
That
opportunity
failed
they
you.
had. But if you want to stand by yourself with no, so you have to have good grades. And
I agree. And
yeah.
it's not just about grades as well. I think you talked a lot about networking with the people who matter, especially in Uganda. So for instance, I remember we had an exchange program when we were at the end of our 4th year. I don't know if you're
Oh,
still.
yeah.
Yeah. At the end of our 4th year, we had an exchange program in which they would take the top people in the class, the highest CGPAs, and they would take them to different universities around the world. And at the time that when our year came, so for me, I also had, I think, forward thinking, and I had all these big dreams for myself. I kind of never saw myself in Uganda long term. Like, I wanted to go out there somewhere. Initially, US, because a lot of us want to go to the US in Uganda. The US path is well known. So I went to the lady who was in charge of Dean's building, eh? Well, not Dean's secretary. The one was in charge of putting up the list. So I went and I asked her, like, to get on this list, to go to Yale, because I wanted to go to Yale, eh? What do you have to do?
Sorry, I went to Yale for your part.
You didn't go for your part, you went for your part, but I really wanted to go to Yale.
I represented you at Yale.
You represented me. So then the lady told me, all you have to do is have the highest number, the highest, I think, four people, four CGPAs go to Yale. And then I asked her, what about technical know-who? Like, do I have to know someone or what? Then she said, it used to be there, but no more now. And this was in my first year that I asked. So when I found out, I said, okay, who are the top CGPAs in our class? So I went and I asked people. I asked Mtegeki, what's your CGPA? And then he told me, then I told him, who has the highest CGPA? Then he told me, Kenneth. Kenneth has CGPA. I was like, what is CGPA? Like, okay. It was in 4 points, those ends. Remember, first year. And then mine was in threes. Do you know why? Because the very first module that we did, you remember ethics? They marked us so strangely. And then I even got a D. I got a 50 something. That's the first mark on my transcript, and it's the worst. They gave us an opportunity to repeat, but at that time, I didn't know the future, which I wasn't interested. I said, I'm not repeating. So my CGPA was low, was in threes. So I worked so hard. I said, like, I want my CGPA to reach as high as it can be. And so when the time came, now I was in the top, at least, because now instead they increased the numbers. They now made us,
20.
20. And yet they wanted only eight. And on the list, I was number eight. I was number eight on the list, but did I go? Did I go anywhere? Of course, I did not. I did not go anywhere. And I think what happened, I don't know if it's true, but what happened is that now this is when now the technical know-hows came in somehow, because now they made us do interviews and what. And then I think there were people who had been knowing people, knew the right people, had never spoken to these lecturer people, but me, I was not interested in anything. I used to go to class only. I don't go in extracurricular activities that will benefit me. So if you're out there, in the end, like, I'm not bitter or anything. Like, I'm happy with how my life has
It's
turned
not
out.
bitter. People who knew who. No, we went on merit.
No. I mean, it was merit, yes. But then there was also now these other things that came up in. Now they had to sort out. You get, it was no longer, we had to do interviews as well. You get,
Yeah.
They added in other things.
It was
So,
actually my first interview ever in life,
life,
and I aced it.
No, Kenneth, you had to, and you had to go. I think it would have been unfair if you hadn't. So they start bringing us in interviews, which she. So I think my point is that you should do your grades, yes, but also you should try and look at extracurricular opportunities. Like, there were other clubs, these research things,
Oh
right?
yeah. So I was still talking about that. So I knew I needed, because there's so much writing as you apply for these things. Write your personal statement, write this, write that. So I joined so many clubs. I joined the Research and Writers Club, which had different teachings about how to write. I didn't know how to write, you guys. What's it called? Journal paper. I did so bad. But I did know how to write. And I think that club helped me to think about how to write and how to get, how to write. It helped me learn how to write at that time. So I joined those clubs. So imagine, and then I went through the ranks to being president in that club from first years until 5th year when I was president. And it's not the only club that I was part of the Catholic community. So St. Augustine Catholic community, my hall of residence, as part of a student professionalism and ethics club. Speak as I was part of the Baganda Medical Students Association, BAMSA, Makerere University Baganda Medical Students Association, BAMSA. As part of several things.
So basically, I think it's not just about academics, especially
Yeah.
when you're applying out there. Number
Yeah.
one, for applying, but also for networking, because how are you going to start knowing these lecturers? You might not know them from class, because in class you're like 50 people.
Yeah. So actually, most of my mentors turned out to be patrons for those clubs. So especially for the Research and Writers Club, I got to interface with my mentor who has been giving me reference letters to different places. From my Research and Writers Club.
Yes.
Yeah,
So
so
try and do other things, people. Don't just go and read and go back to.
yeah. He didn't actually teach me that much, but whenever you'll be like, oh, I know Kenneth. I'm like, whenever I would hear him say, oh, I know Kenneth, I'll be like, Yes, he knows me.
Yes. So you should try and get to know the right people.
Yeah, you should
Try
get
and
to
get
try,
the
you
right
should try
people to
to
know
see.
you.
Yeah, you should try to have people who know you.
Yes.
Yeah. And who are like deans, who are active in the student life.
Yes.
Yeah, who are people who are active in student lives. Not people you see for one day and you don't know what they are doing. Yeah. And these days it's easy. You can find out what people are doing because you can check their LinkedIn. They are active on many platforms.
Send
Yeah.
them an email. Send them a cold email, like we
Yeah. So I would send him an email saying, "Oh, update. So now I'm doing my intern. No, I'm doing my elective placement in Arua regional referral. I would like to learn this, this, this." Oh, okay. Thank you for letting me.
Yes. You
Yeah. Then I'll be like, "Oh, it's been long hearing from you. I'm now an intern at Zambia Hospital doing this and this."
Yes. You have to tie on the person basically. And don't be ashamed or afraid. Because you as the mentee, you're the one who has more to gain from the relationship.
Yes, you have to drive, and you have to drive the relationship because people are busy.
Yes, people are busy. So I love that as well. So
So, and then as a student, I also got a chance to work to join a research group at the Infectious Diseases Institute. I joined it. They put up a call for a medical student to be part of a research group. Then I applied, got interviewed, and I joined the research group. And you guys have been in that group up to now.
wow.
Yeah.
So
So
look
when
out
I
for
finished my
opportunity.
internship, they called me back. "Oh, Kenneth, come and we work." Then I went back to work on the same group. And it's been the group that has built me really. Taught me how to write publications. And it has really built me up to now. It's made me. Yeah, but I joined it in my fourth year of medical school.
So look for opportunities, as many opportunities as you can, and join the opportunities. Apply, keep applying for whatever you want, and you'll get it. So I
Yeah.
think that's really admirable.
And if you want to go to Yale, get top grades and go to Yale. It
Get
might be your first flight. It was my first flight out of Uganda.
Yes, get top grades. Get top grades. And so thank you so much for that. I'm sure it's going to help someone.